Just want to help stimulate the discussion. Now, Mark Sutcliffe said in the other room that there is the story of nuclear to be told. And all of us have a role, all of us in this room have a role in describing and articulating that story, and this is the time to do it. And all I'm doing here is indicating a few thoughts as to what might be elements of that story. Some of them you know already, some of them you've been out talking about. But just to keep that in mind, and maybe you have some to add to it. So, am I doing this right? We are not moving ahead here. There we go, the first one. I'm going to go back one. Okay, we start with that. The Ontario refurbishment announcements, and as you can see, constitute the largest investment in low-carbon energy over the next 25 to 30 years. And I think that we should be more outgoing and articulate in talking about that investment. It is a low-carbon investment. It's a remarkable project that will extend out in the next years. And I may be wrong here, but I'm assuming it's the biggest in North America and beyond. And why do we not sort of make more of that as an impressive project that this industry is delivering on? Our uranium exports and the export of CANDU reactors, I mean, this is something that I think gets overlooked. We have contributed over the years through these exports. I haven't done the data manipulations required, and I would invite anyone who's got a mind for that to start calculating. But if we just assume 25, 30 years of Canadian uranium exports, our CANDU technology in a number of countries abroad, and hopefully more in the future, is that we have already contributed significantly to the reduction of carbon emissions by avoiding them through this technology. And yet we never bothered to claim that. I don't see we have to harp on it, but we can say there's already a contribution, let's do even more. Our technology is a strategic asset. I come from the Department of Foreign Affairs, and I see this as something that on which we build our relations with countries. It's a strategic relationship. You don't just sell a reactor or be involved in a civil nuclear project with a country, have a nuclear cooperation agreement, and say after 5 years, well, that's about it, we're out of here. It is a longer-term relationship, and with countries like India and China, of course, and we can add other countries to it, it is a fundamental part. And it also gives us credibility when we speak on nuclear safety, non-proliferation, security, any of the big issues in international fora that affect our security and our foreign policy, we have credibility because of our technology. This is something looking at in Ontario about the kind of integration that's going on with the support of the IESO and others. I think we have an unusual jurisdiction in Ontario that's seeking to bring together, integrate more and more renewable. At the same time, power a fairly important, of course, and complex modern economy, ensure that the electricity is there and it is clean electricity, integrating hydro, nuclear, as well as renewables. And that, to me, is the pattern of the future. It may be reproduced in different combinations and in different jurisdictions, and I mean internationally, but Canada and Ontario can go forward and say, we know we're learning how to do it, we're getting better at it, and we can talk to you about our best practices, how to operate it, how to regulate it, et cetera. So there is a real product there, whatever you want to call it, the hybrid model or something that we can take forward. Well, we'll see what the Supreme Court challenge will do with this. But if there is a greater demand for low-carbon electricity from south of the border, then obviously our provinces should be and would like to respond and get those markets. And in Ontario, with 61% of the clean electricity, of the electricity, and even more of the clean electricity coming from the nuclear power, then this is something where markets may expand and indeed increase the demand for electricity. If you project that forward and you see more appetite south of the border for clean electricity coming from Ontario, then we have a demand rise going forward, and that has good implications for our industry. This one, of course, there'll be speculation on it, and there'll be discussion later on today on the electrification. I don't think the analyses have been done enough yet, and we're all working on them, But if you're looking at greater electrification of our economies, then who's going to be providing the clean power to support that? And we think we have a very important role in there. And this is my final slide. I think that we should be not challenging, but let's discussing on a broader scale with all the different energy systems that Canada is blessed with, is all of them have different environmental impacts. All of them have waste. All of them have impact on flora and fauna. They have environmental footprints. They have contamination risks. They have decommissioning, management of the future of the waste. And how is each one of them dealing with it? And I think that's an important thing, just to have a playing field of discussion where you are not just singling out nuclear, say, well, you have a waste aspect to your work, I think is much broader, and we could look at that.